Welcome back. Big business takes cues from Washington, D.C. Executives are awaiting the next steps in the Republican plan to reform the tax code after an impasse that led to the health care bill getting pulled last week. The White House takes the lead on the centerpiece of President Trump's plan to grow the economy.
I mean, obviously, we're driving the train on this, so I don't want to, I mean, we're going to work with Congress on this, but I think that the president, as you've heard through multiple times, the president would be very clear, this is a huge priority for him, something that he feels very passionately about.
We've got Sam Zell with us this morning, one of the most influential real estate investors in the world right now. And Sam, I know you're just back from Abu Dhabi and Israel. Does Trump's name come up when you're talking to international investors? Tell us about what the rest of the world is talking about.
I don't think that any conversation exists anywhere that doesn't start and end with Trump. A lot of it is disbelief, but a lot of it is comfort that the United States is delivering a consistent, predictable policy. I think that overall, the Trump phenomena has certainly brought the United States back into the center of everybody's conversation.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, and yet you've obviously you're a huge investor in the U.S., but you're investing across the world, emerging markets, Mexico. Tell us where your big bets are right now internationally.
We just made a big investment in Brazil. We've been in Brazil before. We've exited Brazil.
Are they cleaning up the corruption there?
I think so. I hope so. I believe so. I'll let you know in a couple of years. Mm. But the environment has for sure changed. And, like buying distressed assets, in a recession in the United States, there's a lot of distressed assets and distressed businesses in Brazil that need new capital, and that's going to create opportunities for foreign investors to participate.
How are you finding things in China? Is that a market that's welcome, that you're welcome, or are they trying to be too restrictive on the capital going in?
I think it's not so much restrictions on the capital going in, it's that the amount of capital that exists is very significant.
And wanting to go to China?
No. Internal capital.
Okay.
In other words, maybe it's not the kind of capital that you and I would think is, quote, good capital, i.e., local political arms borrowing money to invest in, quote, money-making operations. But there's no shortage of capital in China, and therefore the foreign investor, generally speaking, is second.
Kind of priced out, huh?
And priced out.
Squeezed out.
Hometowned out.
Yeah.
What about Mexico, Sam, and the possibility that we renegotiate NAFTA as well?
Well, I think that there's a lot of case to be made for the renegotiation of NAFTA. I think it's important to understand that we call NAFTA a trade policy. But NAFTA was 50% trade, 50% foreign policy. The objective of that foreign policy was to reduce immigration, illegal immigration. It worked. It worked big time. But in effect, it's being charged against against the normal trade agreement, when in fact it was a policy agreement.
Built a bridge in Mexico.
I built a bridge from San Diego into the Tijuana airport, and last year was its first full year. It's called the Cross Border Express. We handled 1,300,000 people coming across. We expect the number to be 1,000,008 this year. And no matter what happens, I think Mexico is going to do fine.
So what's your take on the border wall? Is a tariff against Mexico realistic? What's your take on all of the conversation around Mexico and this border wall right now, since you've got so many investments there?
I guess I think that there will be some kind of token wall, but I don't think it's going to have much of an impact. I think the Mexico-U.S. connection is far too strong for any shift in policy to have anything other than a short-term impact. Mexico has become, we used to talk about China being the manufacturing center of the U.S. Well, Mexico has become the manufacturing center of the U.S., and frankly, that's a plus.
You think Mexico pays for that wall?
I'm not into wall paint.
You don't know. Okay, we don't know. But you do expect a token wall. We'll see if it's effective or not. A lot of people say, look, what about tunnels underneath? Maybe it won't be effective. Sam, thank you for that.